The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like Moses from among you, from your brothers. It is to him you shall listen, for God will put his words in his mouth, and he shall speak to you all that God commands him to speak. But until then, he'll send godly men. They'll be faithful and bold, calling all to repent. They will sing songs of joy and cry tears of lament. But their hope will be sure in the God who can cure our sins. They were Joel, Jonah, Amos, Hosea, Isaiah, Micah, Nahum, Zephaniah, Habakkuk, Jeremiah, Daniel, Ezekiel, Obadiah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. That's Jehjahim, Nahash, Deo, Hazem. Jehjahim, Nahash, Deo, Hazem. Joel told us of the day of the Lord. Jonah was swallowed by a great big fish. Amos told us how we ought to treat the poor. Hosea married Gomer, but it wasn't his wish. Isaiah told us all about a child who would be born. And Micah said his birthplace would be little Bethlehem. And Nahum, my Nineveh, did pour out all his scorn. Zephaniah told of judgment on Jerusalem. Habakkuk warned that Babylon would take Judah away. Jeremiah revealed the law that would be written on our hearts. Daniel was thrown in the den because he chose to pray. Ezekiel saw an army of dry bones get a fresh start. Obadiah prophesied against Edom for their sin. Haggai demanded that the holy temple be rebuilt. Zechariah spoke of victory, a branch one day would win. Malachi confronted much of Judah's guilt. That's Jehjahim, Nahash, Deo, Hazem. Jehjahim, Nahash, Deo, Hazem. There are so many more that we have not gone through. So far we've sung about a small group called the Writing Prophets, but here's some more just to name a few. Noah cursed Canaan after getting a little drunk. Jacob said the scepter was in Judah to stay. Moses spoke of a prophet like himself who was to come. Samuel said that Eli's priesthood would be taken away. And David spoke of his Lord who would soon sit at God's right hand. And Nathan called out David for his sin against man and God. Elijah put to shame Baal's prophets by the Lord's command. And Elisha was the very man of God. Now try to recall Malachi, the last of the prophets before 400 years of silence. But that silence was broken when John the Baptist came on the scene as a voice of one crying out in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord. He said, repent now, our Lord's almost here. His glory and power will fill you with fear, but his merciful love can wipe away all your tears. He's a Lamb of God, the one who can cure our sin. He was preparing us for Jesus, the prophet like Moses, raised up to set us free, commanding sin and death, and let his people go with all authority. Jesus, our curse-bronze serpent, lifted up forever with him will be. He has set us free.